Students, today I am going to give you additional lecture on apoptosis. This lecture is only to clarify your knowledge about the apoptosis. Few new knowledge has been given into this, which may come into your MCQ test, but others are only to understand this process to reinforce your previous knowledge. So let us start with it. Now you can see apoptosis. The term apoptosis is a Greek word and it means falling off. It means like as the old leaves fall down from the trees, it is analogous to that. So the body aging cells fall down or age after this process, it falls down. It means to say that. Now we shall discuss the history that we have not discussed earlier of the apoptosis. In year 1842, Carl Vogt first described principle of apoptosis, while in 1885 the Walter Fleming first associated term apoptosis with programmed cell death. In 1965, after so long period, John Kerr used an electron microscope to differentiate programmed cell death, that is apoptosis, from the traumatic cell death, that is necrosis. In the year 1972, John Foxton Ross Kerr and Alastair R. Curry and Andrew Wille, all these gentlemen published the paper The Natural Process of Cell Death, that is apoptosis. And in the year 2002, the Nobel Prize for Medicine was awarded on apoptosis jointly to Sidney Brenner, Horwich, and John E. Sulston. So these are the knowledges, and you should remember it. It may come into your test, or it may come into your further test, forthcoming other tests also. Now we shall go to the regulation of the opening of mitochondrial transition pore, about which you have learned in the apoptosis chapter. Now this mitochondrial transition pore is also known as MAC. MAC means mitochondrial apoptosis induced channel, and also known as MOMP. MOMP means mitochondrial outer membrane permeabilization pore. So these are three names of the same pore, same channel, and this channel is meant to release the protein cytochrome C from mitochondrial intermembranous space into cytosol. So that is the purpose of this pore. Now this is facilitated by the regulation of this one is facilitated by the BCL2 family of proteins. This name BCL2 has been given because in the B cell lymphomas, these proteins are overexpressed due to chromosomal translocation. That's why the proteins of this family are known as BCL2 family, B cell lymphoma. Now, the BCL2 family proteins are of three types. As you already know, I will again repeat. First one is the anti-apoptotic proteins. These are BCL2, BCLXL and MCL1. And all these are with 4 BH domains, 1 to 4 BH domains. They are present in cytosol, endoplasmic reticular membranes and outer mitochondrial membranes. They prevent the opening of MAC and synthesized after induction by survival signals like growth factors, which withdrawal, that means withdrawal of the growth factor or survival signal, do not prevent MAC opening. That is, MAC opening is facilitated, that gives rise to the apoptosis. Now here you can see this figure is representing the MAC, that is the transition pore, and here it is anti-apoptotic protein. It is preventing, it is closing this MAC. So in that way, it facilitates enclosure of this MAC. Now, we will switch over to pro-apoptotic effector proteins. These are BACs and BAKE, and these are also with 4 BS domains, and upon activation by pro-apoptotic sensor proteins, BACs and BAKE oligomerize in outer mitochondrial membrane, and the oligomers open the MAC and inhibits anti-apoptotic proteins, effector proteins also. Anti-apoptotic proteins effort to open MAC. You can see here, this is the oligomer which is formed by the oligomerization of the BACs and BAKE. Now this is a schematic diagram which tries to say, show the how the MAC is opened. This protein comes between the pore and it tries to open. That is one function of this pro-apoptotic protein, effector protein. Another function is this antagonizes the fault of the anti-apoptotic proteins to close the MAC. Now come to the pro-apoptotic sensor proteins. These are BIM, BID, BAD, PUMA and NOXA, and with these are having only 3 BS domains. Hence it is also called BH3 only proteins, which after being activated by genotoxic oxidative and ER stresses activate pro-apoptotic effector proteins. So that is a quiet revision of the things you have already known. Now we shall switch over to the therapeutic activation of apoptosis. What are the conditions in which there is therapeutic trial is given to activate the process of apoptosis? For example, in pathological conditions, when apoptosis is inhibited, for example, proteins E6 and E7 bind with P53 protein and retinoblastoma protein respectively to inactivate their inhibitory effects on cell cycle from G1 to S phase in carcinoma cervix. That is the pathophysiology of the carcinoma cervix also. Now, another example is, in the similar way, it also activates the cell cycle by cell cycle is activated by the viral infections, inflammatory processes, autoimmune diseases. So in order to control these diseases, apoptosis is activated by these means. For example, enhancing death receptors for ligands by the tumor necrosis factor and TRAIL, and by antagonizing anti-apoptotic proteins by the use of SMAC mimetic drugs which inhibit IAP, inhibitory of apoptosis, inhibitors of the apoptosis, that is cytosolic physiologic inhibitors of the apoptosis. Fourth one is use of Herceptin and Gleevec which blocks the survival signals. And fifth one is the addition of P53 MDM2 complexes which activate proteasomal degradation of inhibitory protein P53. Now, come here. Here I have shown the inhibition of the apoptosis. What are the conditions in which the apoptosis is inhibited? One is the physiologic inhibition, and by tumor suppressor protein P53, physiological suppression of the apoptosis is done, and it is synthesized by transduction of tumor suppressor gene T53 after induction through alpha and beta interferon pathway. Now, what does this tumor suppressor protein P53 do? You already know, I will just revise. It is stimulated by DNA damage, that is this protein, and inhibits progression of DNA replication from G1 to S phase of cell cycle to allow a breathing time for DNA repair. Therefore, mutation of T53 gene allows damaged DNA to cross G1 S phase checkpoint of the cell cycle and proliferate with defective genetic constitution. That is the thing, that is the physiological thing, and its abnormality will produce that. Second one is the genetic inhibition of the apoptosis. It is done by the GAP. GAP means X-linked inhibitor of apoptosis protein. It binds to the processed form of caspase 9, which suppresses activity of cytochrome C, as occurs in H460 cells linked to pulmonary carcinoma. Now, next one is the therapeutic inhibition. As you have seen, the therapeutic activation in diseases with increased hyperactive apoptosis. The diseases in which there is hyperactive apoptosis, like neurodegenerative disorders like Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, spinal muscle atrophy, or hematological disorders, tissue damage, or AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. These are the conditions in which there is hyperactive apoptosis. And in these conditions, the apoptosis is therapeutically inhibited to control the situation. And how it is done? It is done by activating anti-apoptotic and inhibiting pro-apoptotic proteins as below. Number one is blocking fast-induced apoptosis by BCL2, which inhibits release of cytochrome C and SMAC. Second is FLIP, which blocks caspase 8 and 9. Third is the CRMA, that is cytokine response modifier. These are blocked. Second is by increasing IAPs to block caspase 9 and 3. Third is the inhibition mediated by AKT protein kinase acting by two pathways. Number one pathway is phosphorylation of AKT protein causing inhibition of BAS part. BAS is a part of the BCL2 family protein which enhances the cell survival. And second, by the activation of IKK alpha, that is inhibitor of nuclear factor kappa B kinase subunit alpha. It is causing NFKB activation, which promotes expression of anti-apoptotic gene BCL2 with increased cell survival. Now the last thing I would revise is there are different other types of the caspases also, as you have learned. Besides that, and I will summarize all those. The initiator caspase, of the intrinsic pathways are 9 and 2, while of extrinsic pathway are 10 and 8, and of the executioner caspase, they are 3, 6 and 7. So that's all about this, and I will finish my lecture here only. Okay, thank you.